Recall, one of the iconic buildings on Penn State's campus. Today, it is the site of championship gymnastics presented by Pure Silk. The first of two sessions from Happy Valley here today. The Women's Big Ten Gymnastics Championship here on the Big Ten Network. Welcome to the most exciting time here in the Big Ten women's gymnastics season, championship time. And by this time, this day is done, we will have a 2014 Big Ten champion. Now to get there, we have to go through two different sessions. The afternoon session taking place today featuring the 5th through 8th seeds, Iowa, Michigan, Michigan State, and Ohio State. And then later at 5 p.m. Eastern, the top four seeds, Illinois, Minnesota, Nebraska, and Penn State. Important to mention that you can have a Big Ten champion and come out of either session. Time now to welcome in our gymnastics analyst from all season long, the former Olympian, Sean Johnson. And though you didn't compete at the college gymnastics level, you know all about championship level competition.
Championships is what athletes live for, and gymnasts, whether going for a gold medal or a conference title. It's going to be exciting to be at my first championships, but an honor to crown the champion at the end.
We're happy to have you here as well. Michigan trying to make history as well. No one has come out of the afternoon session to win this championship. They are ranked the highest in the Big Ten, and to do it, Joanna Sampson, their all-arounder, is going to have a big day.
She is a force to be reckoned with. She's hit 39 for 39 routines this season, which is unheard of. She's ranked 5th in the all-around in the nation, and I really think she's going to be the team leader for Michigan tonight.
Noted the 2013 Big Ten Gymnast of the Year. Again, her team is ranked the highest out of all the other Big Ten teams trying to make history here this afternoon. We have Championship Saturday underway in the first rotation with the Wolverines going to the vault, Iowa to the bars, Ohio State to the beam, and Michigan State to the floor when we come back. Gymnastics on BTN is presented by Pure Silk Moisturizing Shave Cream for Women, for legs that look and feel like Pure Silk. Your Big Ten championship weekend here. One of two sessions. Here is the afternoon session, and plenty of Wolverine fans, plenty of Spartan fans. In fact, all four of the teams competing here in the afternoon session, well represented by their fan base here this afternoon. Here is your women's standings going into this event with the two sessions, Minnesota and Nebraska, tying for the regular season championship there at 6-1. Now Michigan sitting at 5-2, as we had mentioned, is still the highest ranked team nationally amongst all the other Big Ten teams. No team has come out of the afternoon session to win the title. We talked to Bev Plotkey about exactly that.
We're challenged. We put ourselves in this situation, and what I know about this team is that they have a lot of determination and a lot of fight in them, and they've proven that to me time and time again, and they're going to prove it again today.
So time will tell if we get to see a little bit of history here today. Michigan will have to put up a big number. Bev Plotkey telling me yesterday that she is eyeing maybe a mid-197 number to put up here this afternoon to be able to compete there in the evening session. Their first rotation starts out with Shirelli, Zachariah, Sugiyama, Bielstein, with Sampson there, and Shepard. Austin Shepard, of course, the premier vaulter there in that lineup there for the Michigan Wolverines. That is your first rotation there for Michigan, your first rotation for Iowa on the bars, and Larissa Libby in her 10th season, bringing Glover, Doherty, Drenth, Huntley, Metcalf, and Hare there on bars. That's one of the most challenging events that they've had all season long. She said, replacing one gymnast is hard enough. Replacing four is about ridiculous, which they have had to do because of injuries and some transfers. Over to the beam, this is Ohio State's first event. The toughest rotation, you can argue, in a quad meet. Kerry Fagan, the head coach, bringing Grady, Funchess, Dunn, Schaefer, Apley, and Miller to that starting order there in the beam lineup. And finally, Kathy Klagis and the Michigan State Spartans tied for 38th in the RQS and trying to get in the top 36 here after this afternoon. They start on floor. Holmes, Frederick, Burke, Cartwright, Legowski, and Danny Levy will round things off, the senior there for the Michigan State Spartans. A minute ago, we got underway, and here is moments ago, Michigan getting started. Talia Shirelli, the freshman. We will see her on vault and beam here this afternoon.
She warmed up with her Yurchenko layout full. That was beautiful. Going in, round up, I guess, in layout full. little under-rotated since she had to hop forward, but good form.
Again, let's remind folks, a little hop would be what kind of deduction here from the judges?
A judge can take anywhere from a tenth to even up to 5/10, depending on how big it is. So that one I would say would be around 2 or 3.
Okay. We'll update you as these scores come in. That was Shirley's 8th time leading off here. We're bending over to bars. And we are waiting on Allie Glover to get things underway here for Iowa. Glover, one of the all-around competitors. I'm sorry, Jordan Doherty here for Iowa. A freshman. We'll see her on bars and on vaults. The Hawkeyes going with the same names that they went with in the quad meet last weekend. Just kind of flipping around the rotations there in the bottom part of the order.
Now, Jordan is a powerhouse. She attacks every event, and you'll see she's aggressive.
As we wait on Doherty here to begin her routine, all four of these events, I want to remind you, like with any quad meet, are taking place here at the same time. We're going to try to hop around and show you as many gymnasts as we can in all four rotations. And if you stick with us here this afternoon and through the evening, you will see 6 top 25 teams here from the Big Ten. 2 in the top 10 teams, including Michigan and Nebraska. You'll see Michigan here in the afternoon session. Of course, Nebraska ranked 9th in the country. You'll see the Huskers compete there in the evening session. A last-minute substitution here. Nicole Arts in at the vaults here for Michigan.
Going in with another Yurchenko layout fall. Huge height off the vault and extension. Again, just that hop at the landing. I would say a judge would take about 2/10 for that.
One thing to mention here that's different than what you would see throughout the dual meets when we broadcast these throughout the year, you usually have 2 judges on every event in the dual and the tri meets. In these conference meets, these conference competitions, there are 4 judges. As you can see now, we're now in a standstill here between all these different events. But to finish my thought, in the conference meet, there are 4 judges. You drop the top and the bottom scores, and the 2 middle scores are averaged out. And the same judges will judge the afternoon and the evening sessions here, and they'll only stay on their one event. Back to Jordan Doherty here for Iowa on the bars.
Starting off with a nice connection, giant fold to a bail. She didn't quite hit handstand. Just her dismount, winding up for a double layout. Great extension. Again, it's just that hop on the landing.
Yeah, what caused her to take that little hop there?
A lot of times it's your air sense. You want to land at the perfect angle. And so when you open up early or you go too hard, that causes you to have to take a step at the end.
Allie Glover before her, recording a 9.67. And we'll update you on Jordan Doherty's score when we get it. Sachi Sugiyama, live here on the vaults.
Yurchenko, 1.5. Beautifully done with a stuck landing. I saw her do that in warm-up, and it was, I don't know, just as good.
She could not wait to get back. We'll take another look at this. She could not wait to greet her coach and her teammates after this.
You can see here how much height she gets off that vault, opening up and sticking the landing. It's going to be a huge score.
The other thing that's different about these championships, the teams have to sit in those corrals and they can't run and congratulate the team. The gymnast has to come back to them. Here's in the 2012 vault winner here for Sachi Sugiyama.
Wow. I'd say vault's her specialty.
So a 9.7 for Shirelli. We saw her vault to lead things off for Michigan as we look at the freshman, Tennille Funchess, here for Ohio State.
Another power athlete. She has big skills and doesn't hold back. First series here. Russian spring layout step out. switch sleep straddle. A little bobble there, but I don't know if a judge would take anything for that.
She had a stress fracture in her back in January. Missed the first 3 weeks of training. Carrie Fagan, though, calls her a stud. Look out for her.
She's coming back strong. I've seen her compete a couple times this season and doesn't seem to be bothered by it. Solid routine so far. She's stuck everything. Great form. Just her dismount. Round off double back. Something you don't see in college gymnastics too often.
And from a freshman.
Just that step on the landing.
Natalie Bielstein from Michigan just moments ago. Take a look at her vault here from Michigan.
Another 2.5. I think she's got glue on her feet.
Judges thought so too. She gets a 9.95 there on that event. And just before her, we saw Sachi Sugiyama, a 9.875 on her vault score. That before her, Rima Zachariah tying a season high and career high as a 9.75. Heading over to floor here for Michigan State. This is Lisa Burt, one of the all-arounders here for the Spartans, a sophomore. Take a look at her first pass coming up.
She goes for a front layout 1.5 to a back layout, a difficult combination since you're changing direction so much.
Michigan State right now 38th, and the top 36 teams in the country will go to regionals. So they are looking to improve their RQS here after this afternoon.
Showing some unique choreography. Huge pass, double pike. Sticks the landing and shows great control.
Lisa Burt, third all-around competition just last weekend. Really come on strong here lately towards the end of the year here for Michigan State. Gearing up for her final pass.
That was her front layout 1.5. Kind of playing it safe in the last pass, which I would say is smart. A lot of girls go for harder passes, but very well done.
Moments ago, Mariah Huntley here on the bars, a sophomore. We will see her in three different events here this afternoon. Originally scheduled to be the anchor here for Iowa, moved up to the fourth spot here for the Hawkeyes.
Starting out the giant fall to a release move, Ginger. Huge height, leg separation, a little bit in form. Just has her dismount left. Winding it for a double layout. Great extension, stuck landing.
Stuck it.
Great job.
She just added bars this year. Really has slowly added, came into competition for Iowa last year and has slowly added a couple of events in addition to the floor, which we start out on. Joanna Sampson, moments ago here for Michigan on the vault.
She's got a very strong vault. Your Chenko layout fall, huge height, small little step there that she tries to hide, but again, she's the force to be reckoned with and should be a huge score.
That one coming out is a 9.85. Want to mention, too, Natalie Bielstein's score changed to a 9.925. Originally, it was recorded as a 9.95. We're changing that now to a 9.925. So a 9.85 there for Joanna Sampson. Melanie Schaefer, one of the all-around competitors here for Ohio State, a Pittsburgh, Pennsylvania native. Plenty of family and friends here in attendance here in Happy Valley.
And I'd say starting out on beam as your first rotation is never easy. It's the one that takes the most concentration and You want the nerves to be gone by the time you get there.
We will take a look at head coach Kerry Fagan. They did not perform well last weekend on beam against Michigan State in the quad. We'll get to that story in just a second, but first we want to peek in just moments ago on Austin Shepherd here from Michigan.
Huge vaulter. Goes for an Yurchenko ball stuck landing. You can see when she gets off the vault, she gets more height than any of them.
And Austin Shepherd recording a 9.95 on that. We head back now to Melanie Schaefer on beam. Schaefer recording a 9.175. She fell last weekend. This is certainly a redemption event for her here today.
Looking extremely solid so far. She stuck her jump pass and her flight series. You can see her talking to herself there. A lot of times gymnasts have kind of key notes and things to think about before each skill.
I saw her routine though. She looks much more relaxed this week than she did last week.
She does. A lot of times you can see with gymnasts, they're a little shaky and hesitant and nervous, and that's just kind of the anxiety coming out. She seems very calm. Dismount. Double twisting layout with a stuck landing.
I'd say redemption was met there for Melanie Schaefer. A big score there for Ohio State. Going back to bars live, Sydney Hare, one of her three events here this afternoon for Iowa.
Huge, Ginger. I'm on the wrong event.
You're still thinking about Austin Shepherd's vault.
Great fail to a handstand. All she has is a dismount. Double layout, stuck landing. No wonder she's the anchor. It should be a very huge, very big score.
Originally scheduled to be in the fifth spot there for Iowa, as you mentioned. Move now to the anchor spot. Mariah Huntley, we saw her routine. That one coming in as a 9.65 there for Huntley. And just a moment ago, Angel Metcalf in the fifth spot.
Iowa is showing a lot of progress in this week, the last one.
A very young team, no seniors on this team. About six walk-ons that they've had to use all season long.
You can see on her release move there, she got a little close. Bail not quite in the handstand. Another huge double layout, small hop. Be another consistent score.
That was just moments ago, and that score coming in as a 9.75. So some solid scores here for bars here for Iowa as we head back to beam. Victoria Apley here for Ohio State. Buckeyes have three all-arounders competing here today. You just saw one in Melanie Schaefer. Here's another, Victoria Apley.
Flight series here by handspring layout step out. Holding it together. You can tell she was a little off, but stayed on. Straddle full. One of the more difficult jump elements you can do because you have to lose complete sight of the beam and try to land back on it. Switch leap to a one-arm back handspring. Their dismount. Another consistent team. Going for a round off, double twisting layout. Pretty much stuck landing.
Five routines for Ohio State on the beam and five hit routines so far here for the Buckeyes. Sailor Miller is the only one left here for Ohio State on that event. Alina Legowski here from Michigan State just moments ago. We'll pick it up here in the middle towards the end of her routine. Legowski and Danny Levy have a couple of incredible and exciting tumbling routines here on the floor.
Handspring 1.5 to a jump. Shows great artistry when you can connect that out of a tumbling pass.
No, we didn't get to see it there because we picked it up in the middle, but she does do a double Arabian there in that routine as well.
A very, very difficult tumbling pass. It's a double flip, but you have to do a half turn in between and land frontwards. That makes any sense at all. But.
Sarah Miller. Little flashback here where she tied for first on the beam in last year's championships held in East Lansing, Michigan. Miller, again, one of those gymnasts like Melanie Schaefer who needs to rebound from last weekend. See the interesting mount that she has on her routine.
She has one of the most difficult skills in her beam routine that has not really even done in the league. Great jump series there. Front aerial back tuck, stuck landing.
For 21st on the beam nationally.
Here's this guy I was talking about. She's a front flip off of one leg and lands on one leg. It's so difficult.
You can see
landing
she
was perfection.
Excited to hit that. Again, Miller and Schaefer normally rocks here for Ohio State. Rocks here this weekend.
They both come back with redemption. I tell you, Ohio State's on a roll.
Hug for the head coach. Last one here on the floor for Michigan State. Danny Levy, a senior. She had a career high in this event last weekend, a 9.85.
Should be her last pass here. Ending it with a double 2.5 twisting layout. Over rotates just a little bit, but hangs on.
Levy wrapping up her routine there. And a number of solid events here in this first rotation. Sometimes you don't know what to get on a championship weekend. Some nerves, but all these gymnasts busting through it with helps from their head coaches and pep talks. We have the second rotation coming up. There you see where the teams go to next. With BTN Connect, see all the Twitter activity from around the conference, get in-game stats, and interact with our experts. Join your favorite team at btn.com/connect and get socially charged. I'll tell you one coach who's charged up after the first rotation is Ohio State head coach Kerry Fagan. You knew because of the performance last weekend on beam, this was going to be a tough start for you guys. What did you see from your team here so far?
I was really happy with the girls. They came through. They were confident. We practiced a lot this week of starting off on beam. The judges were a little slow getting some of the first couple scores up, so I was worried about the nerves kicking in, but they all handled it really well.
And coach, beam is never an easy event to start on, but going to floor, you can kind of take some pressure off. What can we look forward to seeing from the girls?
Hopefully, you know, just sharp dance, big tumbling passes, chest up. Floor's actually been one of the events we've had a little trouble with early in the season, so I'm not ready to sigh of a relief yet. Once we get through this rotation, I think I'll feel a little better.
Coach, don't take off the headset yet. I know this is always an emotional time when you return to your alma mater here at Penn State, and we've got some photos. I know you can't see them, but we can see them, and we're showing them right now of you competing here at Penn State in the mid-90s. Yeah. What do you think?
Hey, I have a lot of great memories here as an athlete. I'd like to make a few more as a coach.
Well, we appreciate the time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Now, Sean, she told me that she always makes a point of visiting Thompson Hall, which was her dorm, to go take a look at that. I want to say hello to her husband, Ryan, as well, who was an offensive lineman there at Penn State in the 90s as well. Here's your vault results here for Michigan after the first rotation. The top vaulter, probably no surprise, the 9.95 for Austin Shepherd, worth another look.
She gets more height off that vault than I've seen from 99% of the girls.
Iowa on the bars. Sydney Hare with the 9-8-5. Hare in the anchor spot here for the Hawkeyes. Here's a look back at Sydney Hare's routine. That's Iowa with a very strong showing. Lowest score that they had was a 9-6 for Jordan Doherty. Ohio State's beam, we heard from the head coach on how happy she was. There you see the 9-8-5 for Sarah Miller. That's a new career high for her. We go back to Miller and take a look here at her dismount.
Well deserved.
Team recording a 49 for that event. We go back to Michigan State here on the floor. And it's the freshman. That's her only event. Alina Legowski, a 9-9 here for Michigan State. You only got one event. You better make it a good one. Legowski, of course, we talked about with that double Arabian there in her routine. Michigan trying to make history and get at least in the mid-197s. Will they lead after the first rotation with a 49.35 here on vault? Trailing them, as we had heard, is Ohio State there on the beam from Carrie Fagan. And Sean, I want to share with you a story that she shared with me about how she conditioned her team on beam going into this weekend. She said, we didn't give them a full warm-up going into beam. We wanted to make it like a neat sort of feel. And they made them hit 6 for 6 in practice and stick at least 3 dismounts. She said it would either take us 10 minutes or 2 hours.
It sounds familiar.
Does it?
I think that's a training technique that comes straight from the elite level. It's all about kind of going into cold sets is what they call them, and just trying to hit your best routine when you're not really prepared.
Well, you see Jillian Carr there from Michigan State. There's always injury storylines to talk about here in this sport. And in warm-ups here for vault, we'll show you again. And this is in the warm-up now. This is, again, what happened here for Jillian Carr.
She lands with her legs completely straight locked out. So, again, no speculation, but I would say those are knees.
We will let you know who will take her spot. Now, again, she's in the leadoff spot there for Michigan State, one of the seniors. And this is a year that Michigan State had started with 11 gymnasts for this event, doing 10 vaults. And because of a series of injuries, they've had to shake up that lineup a little bit. And again, Kathy Klagas will be forced to make a last-minute decision there in her lineup.
I would say as an athlete, you know, injury is almost inevitable. It comes with the sport, but outside of the pain, it's almost more painful just because you work so hard to get there. And, you know, I feel for her. It's never easy. And you always want to get through a competition and never see that happen.
If you're a gymnast, you're going to have injuries. There's no ifs, ands, or buts about it. I know you've had some serious injuries in your career that you had to overcome, like many other gymnasts. We'll start with bars here from Michigan. Sachi Sugiyama in the leadoff spot here for the Wolverines. A first-team All-Big Ten honoree in 2013. No bar titles yet for this year.
Combination giant full to a ginger, huge height, keeps her legs glued together. Transition down to the low bar, back salto, beautifully done. All she has left is her dismount. Full twisting double back with a stuck landing. You said no titles yet. It might change though.
It might change with that routine, absolutely. That's a big score coming up here for Michigan. And what we have seen so far, these Wolverines focus on getting a high team score here in the afternoon session. We'll take another look at that dismount.
Back
She does a full twisting double back, spots the landing, and just glues her feet to it.
Sachi Sugiyama, one of the juniors there, as Jillian Carr is being carried off there for treatment. And again, we will update you on Michigan State's decision there with their vault lineup.
Never easy to see.
Never easy to see, especially as a coach emotionally, but then just technically and logically trying to then fill in that spot. You immediately have to separate your emotion and make a technical decision there for the lineup. We go back to Beam. And this is Iowa.
Back handspring layout step out. Huge flight. Switch side, small little bobble there.
Kayla Tanner has only done Beam. This is really her second time all year long.
Nothing like doing it at championships.
Yeah. You want to be tested? This is the weekend to get tested.
Just your dismount. Front tuck, full twist, duck landing. Great way to start off with the Iowa Hawkeyes.
In a simple routine, you got to keep it simple when you don't have that much experience here in competition.
You want to start out with a solid routine, and a lot of times it does come from the easier ones because you can count on that consistency. It's important to get the confidence going.
Tennille Funchess for Ohio State, the freshman here on floor, one of the all-arounders here for the Buckeyes.
Extremely powerful tumbler. She does some of the bigger tricks of the team.
Saw her beam score there from the first rotation.
First tumbling pass, front layout 1.5. She has great control on her landing.
She's got a little showmanship to her. Looks like in her routine as well.
She has fun. It's always good to see. Front layout full, front pike. Great jump series there. When judges see their jump series, they want to look for full extension and splits and a great control, and she has that.
Final pass here coming up.
With a huge double pike, stuck landing.
Tennille Funchess there on the floor for Ohio State.
Another high-scoring routine.
Yeah, moments ago, we head back to the bars here from Michigan and Nicole Arts. 10 freshman of the week 4 times this year, including this week.
Starting with a release move. Yeah, go straight to a connection and bail to the low bar. Adding a few bonus points there. Another double layout, great extension. Small hop on the landing.
A 9.825 there for Nicole Arts. Sachi Sugiyama recording a 9.9 before her in that routine that we saw. We head back over to the beam for Iowa.
Huge flight series there. Back handspring to 2 layout step-ups in a row. Has a small balance check, but hangs on.
The freshman, Ashley Edlin, has done 3 events all year long here for Iowa. No different here today. A little balance check there.
This is one of those times when I was saying you can tell the athletes that are a little nervous because they just have little wobbles and balance checks here and there. You can tell their nerves are taken over a little bit.
It was so impressive what we saw the Buckeyes do in that first rotation.
Just so huge consistency in control.
Putting a 49 as a team there in that first rotation in the dismount.
Round off, 1.5 layout with a huge step on the landing. Judge can take probably 3/10 for that.
We'll wait on Edlin's score. Caitlin Tanzer recording a 9-6 there before her. Lisa Burt starting things off here for Michigan State, originally slotted in that second spot for the Spartans.
Yurchenko layout full. Almost a stuck landing there.
Of course, Michigan State now competing without Jillian Carr. We showed you getting injured there in the warm-up. So Burt, the first gymnast to go there for Michigan State, and that was moments ago. Her score coming in as a 9.725. Now again, Michigan State says you only count 5 out of the 6 scores. If they get 5 hits and they're satisfied with those 5 scores, they don't have to send a 6th gymnast to that event if they don't want to.
A lot of times it's actually what they will do because their alternate might not be a strong enough vaulter.
One of the seniors here from Michigan, Shelby Geis, has been a staple on the bars and the beam all year long. A middle of the lineup performer here for the Wolverines.
She's probably my favorite bar worker. Her lines are just stunning. You can see her legs are perfectly glued together. She hits every handstand. She's kind of the model and mold of what a judge would want to see on the bars. Giant pull straight to her dismount, double back. Tiny little hop there. A judge might even count that as a stick.
A 9.85. That was moments ago there for Shelby Geis. We head back to the vaults. Moments ago, Ashley Knoll here for Michigan State.
Another Yurchenko layout fall. Huge height off the vault. Kind of pikes in her landing, but sticks it.
I think the judges saw that pike. They gave her a 9.675. We head back to Allie Glover. This is live here on the beam for the Hawkeyes. Glover, a sophomore and an all-around competitor. See her score there on the bars in the first rotation.
Running front tuck. Again, one of the harder skills you can do because it's a blind landing. You don't actually see the beam. You just feel it and kind of hope that you're on the right course.
Is it all about hope? Can you try and find the beam after that?
In practice, a little bit. But just your dismount in the air. Front layout full, stuck landing.
Ashley Edlin, we saw her routine just before. A 9.55 there for Ashley Edlin for ILO. We'll update you on Allie Glover's score. We head back to bars with Austin Shepherd here from Michigan.
Another great bar worker. Again, showing just great lines throughout the entire team. Huge height on her pick up there. Good, perfect straddle back to handstand. Double front dismount. Big step there in the landing. Again, that's that blind landing. You don't see it. You just kind of feel and have to trust where you are.
Austin Shepherd, as far as we know, we will see her again on beam. We've seen her on vaults and bars, and her score coming in is a 9.825. Danny Levy in the third spot here for Michigan State on vault.
Yurchenko layout full. Great form. Not too much height off the vault, just that little hop on the landing.
A little hop on the end, and her score coming in as a 9.7. So Michigan State with a 9.725, a 9.675, and a 9.7 with their first three vaulters. Going back to Joanna Sampson here on the bars here from Michigan. Here at 9.825s from Arts and Shepherd. Those are the lowest scores that Michigan has gotten here on this event so far.
Starting out with her release move. Another huge Takachev. Judges love to see that height on release moves. Shoot over to low bar, hitting her handstands. Michigan shows great form on the bars. Great extension, double layout, stuck landing. Should be another huge score.
Keep an eye on Joanna Sampson. That one coming in as a 9.925. Back over to Mariah Huntley for Iowa. They're on beam.
Connection pass and a fall. When you fall off the beam, it's all about getting back up and completely forgetting about it. If you kind of dwell on it, it will affect the rest of your team.
This is a beam lineup that Larissa Libby had debated, going back and forth between particular gymnasts. Huntley exhibition last weekend here for Iowa. And here's her dismount.
Front layout 1.5 with just a little step on the landing.
A little advice there from the head coach. Go back to Alina Cartwright, the junior here for Michigan State. Now in the fourth spot in vault here for the Spartans.
Chingo layout fall. Huge height off the vault. Great form. Couple little hops there. Didn't show quite enough control on the landing. Judge might take a few tenths for that.
Cartwright's score coming in as a 9.8 there on that event. Natalie Bielstein here from Michigan in the anchor spot there for bars. Joanna Sampson just before her. Her score coming in as a 9.925.
Swing to handstand, straight to a huge release move. Shoot of her, hitting her handstand again. Not giving away any tens. Just her dismount. Full twisting, double back, stuck landing.
Stuck it. Natalie Bielstein had not hit a 9.9 since January 31st. Guess what? The judge has given her a 9.9 there on that routine. Brittany Holmes, the last to go here for the Spartans.
Yurchenko layout. With a step on the landing. One of the easier vaults you can do, but given their situation, it's something that they had to choose to
put Michigan
in.
State, yeah, elected not to add a sixth gymnast there to that event, so they will count those five scores that we showed you. Brittany Holmes, that was a vault that happened moments ago. Her score coming in is a 9.425. Heading over to the floor in Ohio State, Alex DeLuca. This is her only event here this afternoon. Fagan liked it. A couple of solid events here for Ohio State. Angel Metcalf moments ago here for Iowa on the beam. We have talked about it throughout the season. She had to deal with a shin injury all year long. Larissa Libby, though, calling her a tough cookie.
I would say so. A shin injury on the beam is never fun. Jump pass, switch leap to a split three-quarter jump. Showing great control.
This is the event where the scouting report says she's the best and most comfortable on.
I would say that I would agree with that. You can see there's no nerves to be seen. Backhand spring, backhand spring, back layout, step out. Stick that.
You don't see many gymnasts smile on the beam.
No, you
like
don't.
Angel is doing right now. You see him smile on floor. Not many will smile on beam.
Just her dismount here. Ground off, 1.5 twisting layout. tiny little hop there, but a judge cannot not to take that.
Melanie Schaefer, a very Buckeye-themed floor routine. You listen, she does it to the fight song.
First pass, full twisting double back. Very difficult to do.
This is a fun routine to end on.
Getting the crowd and her teammates involved.
You can tell her team loves this routine. And then we transition into the Hang On Sloopy song.
Front layout, full front layout. Perfectly executed.
Said she's had one other gymnast in 10 years do a floor routine to the fight song. Melanie Schaefer, the Pittsburgh native, nailing that routine. That was your final pass. We fill out the final scores here. We will come back here and wrap things up after the first two rotations. We have approached the halfway point. The fans are loving it. We hope you are too. Don't go away. Our coverage of the Women's Gymnastics Championships continues later today with session number two. You'll see four of the top 20 teams in the country, Nebraska, Illinois, Penn State, and Minnesota, plus two of the top 15 all-arounders, and Emily Wong of Nebraska, Lindsay Mabel from Minnesota. It all comes your way at 5 p.m. Eastern tonight. That's live on BTN. But here, we have completed two rotations, and joining us now after those two rotations, head coach for the Michigan State Spartans, Kathy Klages. Let me ask you, to start, we saw Jillian Carr go down there in the warm-ups. What can you tell us about her condition right now?
Well, she hyperextended both knees, and it's pretty severe, and that's about all I can tell you at this point in time. That's about all I know.
And, coach, going into your last two events, you have bars and beam. They're more of the pressure-filled events. What are you saying to your girls? What's their mentality going in?
Well, they're pretty concerned about Jill at this point in time, and so we're just trying to get them focused back onto their gymnastics and telling them to each do their job, and we'll be okay. But we have to just keep focusing on what our jobs are and get them done.
All right, coach, we appreciate the time.
Thank you.
Thank you. Michigan State heading over to the bars. They had a season high last weekend. But for their vault production there, you see Alina Cartwright. And 9-8. We'll take another look here at Cartwright's vault. Again, the Spartans just sending the five gymnasts there to that event. And we'll count five of six scores anyhow. They did not just fill in the Jillian Carr replacement. Michigan on bars. Joanna Sampson leading the way there at 9.925. We'll take another look at her routine in the dismount. I want to mention Natalie Bielstein tying a season high with that 9.9. Iowa's beam results there. Angel Metcalf, a freshman and all-arounder, to 9.85. Take another look. Oh, who is smiling there on the beam? Seems to enjoy it. Over on the floor, Melanie Schaefer, Buckeye battle cry and hang on Sloopy routine, the 9-9. Judges loved it. Here's another look at it, minus the audio.
Yes.
Feel free to sing along if you want.
O-H-I-O.
You're catching on. So after two rotations, Here's your team results. Michigan still leading the way, 98.75. Again, Bev Clocky, and their goal is to get in the mid-197s here after this afternoon session. She thinks if they can do that, that will be good enough to be able to compete for a championship as they watch the final four teams compete in that evening session. We got here after two quad meets last weekend, one at Michigan State, one at Michigan. It was the first time ever that the conference had done something like that. And you're watching some of the best gymnastics teams here in conference play. We have six teams ranked in the top 25. You see Michigan is ranked the highest at eighth, right behind with Nebraska at nine. And Penn State, Minnesota, and Ohio State are three teams ranked in the top 25 you have not seen yet this afternoon. You'll get a chance to do that there in the evening session. As we were saying, the quad meets for all eight of these teams taking place last weekend, and the top two finishers at the Michigan State quad meet and the Michigan quad meet got into that evening session. The other four put into this afternoon session, and again, we can't stress enough that you can put up a score here in this afternoon session that could win the championships, even if you are not competing tonight. We are just wrapping up some of the warm-ups here for these teams as we approach here the third rotation. Ohio State at the vault. You see Iowa there on the floor. You see Michigan State getting prepped and warm up for the bars. And Michigan here will be on the beam. Of course, the Wolverines have that Olympic order where they started on vault, went to bars, are now on beam, and they will finish off on one of their best routines and best events on floor in the fourth and final rotation. Any things that have stand out to you?
I would say Michigan. Their strength on bars and Joanna Sampson, everything. Their power, their consistency and control. It's really standing out to me.
And keep an eye on this, the all-around competition. Joanna Sampson, Melanie Schaefer there of Ohio State are your leaders so far. Pretty tight competition there. And our third rotation is underway. We start with Nicole Arts, the freshman, an interesting mount there on beam.
Judges look for unique artistry. They like to see those unique mounts and dance moves and choreography that kind of makes them stand out. Straddle three-quarter, always difficult landing sideways rather than straight on.
This is her third and final event here this afternoon. She's let off on beam on every meet here from Michigan.
I can see why. She said shows great control, no nerves. Solid routine so far. One leg front tuck, stuck landing. Giving the judges nothing to work with. Or nothing to take away, I should say. Front layout fall, stuck landing. That should be a huge score.
Nicole Arts starting things off in high fashion there for Michigan.
9-9-10-0 in my book.
She led off last week and had a career high 9-9. We'll see what her score will be. Over to Sarah Grady moments ago here for Ohio State on the ball. So a beam score after the first rotation.
Starting off with your Yurchenko layout half. With a pretty big step there at the land or on the landing. Again, not one of the harder vaults, but executed well.
We've seen that a little bit in some of these leadoff spots. These simple routines here for these teams. Sarah Grady's score coming in is a 9.675 there for Ohio State. Again, this is the third rotation in session number one here from Penn State. Women's Gymnastic Championships just moments ago. Michigan State's Brittany Holmes here on the bars. An all-arounder here for the Spartans.
With a combination. Front giant, giant half to a shoot over. Mr. Dismount here. Giant fall to a double back, stuck landing. Fought for it, but she got it.
Tying a season high, or setting a season high and career high, 9.75. Talia Shirelli, the freshman, just hopping on the beam here for Michigan.
Backhand spring layout step out. The stuck landing. Talk about momentum when it comes to teams, and you know they've hit every event so far and they've gained that confidence momentum. It really kind of, it's infectious.
We talked about Ohio State wanting to rebound on beam from their performance last week, and the same story for Michigan. In fact, this event is what cost them the outright Big Ten championships last weekend. They had to count a fall for the first time this season.
Her dismount here. Got a double back. Stuck landing.
Wow!
Great way to start off on beam.
Talia Shirelli. A huge performance. Going back to the vault. Janae Van Putten.
Another Yurchenko layout fall. Very good height off the vault. She kind of hiked in a little bit and took the step. Judge will take probably 3/4 for that. Probably not 4.
But she has actually had some vision issues. Carrie Fagan has told me that sometimes she will go in with 20/80 vision. Has an issue where she has some broken eye vessels at times. It's a condition that has happened the last 2 years. So she gets tested every practice, has to get injections. It's absolutely amazing that she can even vault with a condition like that.
I would say your vision is very important in the sport of gymnastics. So,
you think? Her score coming in is a 9.75. Victoria Apley here moments ago.
Another Yurchenko layout fall. Doesn't quite get enough height off the vault. Probably a little bit deduction in the form area, but well done.
Heading over to Shelby Geis in Michigan here on the beam. On the cool earth, who led off, had a 9.875. We're still waiting on Shirelli's score.
First flight series here. Backhand spring layout step out. Sticks the landing. Again, just like bars with her, her form and her lines are gorgeous. And judges really appreciate seeing that. Her toe point, the way she keeps her legs glued together. Her execution is very nice. Front aerial. She'll just have her dismount left. Cartwheel, 1.5 existing layout.
Looking to rebound, and she does.
Very nice. Should be another high scorer.
One of the falls from Michigan last weekend. The co-captain, the two-time captain, coming with a strong performance this weekend. Alina Cartwright over at the bars here for Michigan. Michigan State. The Spartans here on the bars had a fall in the performance just before Cartwright. So it puts pressure here on the last 4 gymnasts here on this event.
Great series there. She went Shapasnikova to a shoot over. There for a dismount. Giant fall to a double back. Lands off the mat there, which causes her to step. But other than that, great routine.
Update you on Alina Cartwright and her score. Going over to Neil Funches, the freshman here for the Buckeyes moments ago.
Great extension out of her layout. Again, it's just that landing. Landing is so important. It's the difference between a 9-9 and a 9-7.
It's where you get your scores, and she did get a 9-7-7-5 on that vault. She did tie her career high last week with a 9-9. Lindsay Williams back on beam here for Michigan. Has some graceful big jumps here in this routine. Was in the anchor spot last weekend for the Wolverines.
First pass here, side aerial. Again, very challenging because you have to change directions in the air and it kind of throws your balance off. White series by Kansas Lamp. Ooh. About bobble check, but hung on. Caught for that one.
What's the deduction difference by hanging on versus the fall?
If you do a bobble like that, a judge can take anywhere from 2 to 3 tenths. If you fall, it's an automatic 5-10 deduction. Gainer pipe dismount, a stuck landing. A few balance checks, but very well done routine.
A 9.825 last weekend. And some 9.8s across the board there for Michigan so far in this event. And then on Lindsay Williams' score. Back over to the bars here for Michigan State. Ashley Knoll.
Going clear hit, straight through the shoot over. Hits her handstand.
Again, Mackenzie Smith not having the routine that she wanted, so that puts pressure here on these final few routines. Three more to go.
Giant Cold Double Back stuck landing.
Moments ago, back over to the vaults, Ohio State's Melanie Schaefer.
Pachinko layout fall. Just the landing. She had great form, great execution, opened up at the landing. Just a tenth or two.
Her score coming in is a 9.825. Going over to Joanna Sampson, live on the beam. Other than Sarah Miller of Ohio State, she is the top beam worker here in this session.
I was saying earlier, she's hit 39 for 39 routines she's competed this season.
Absolutely amazing. Again, keep your eye on her in the all-around competition. She has won a tie 6 times already this year.
Jump right there is called the sheep jump. It's actually one of the harder jumps you can do because you throw your head back and you don't get to see where you're landing.
A lot of those routines, you don't get to see all those skills, you don't get to see where you're going.
No. That's the difficulty part of it.
4-inch piece of wood all these gymnasts are performing on.
Just your dismount here. Round off, double twisting layout. Little step on the landing. I think she anticipated that stick that she normally has.
Yeah, I was going to say, we don't see that kind of dismount from Joanna Sampson very often. Molly Drenth here from Iowa on the floor. Her final pass here coming up, we believe.
Round off layout, 1.5 front layout. Lands a little short. You can see her legs buckle there, but hangs on to it.
Iowa Hawkeye fans love that. Want to mention, too, Sydney Hare before her. We didn't get to see it, but she tied a career high and season high with a 9.875. Head back over to the bars here for Michigan State, Danny Levy. This will be her final event here for the Spartans today.
Starting off with her release move, huge Jaeger. Overshoot to low bar. Doesn't quite make her handstand there. Full twisting double back. Just step on the landing. Solid routine.
That routine happened moments ago, and that was a 9-7 there for Danny Levy. We head back over to Sarah Miller here on vault for Ohio State. Her shoulder injury has affected her on the block. Let's see how she does here.
Round off half on front by golf. Very difficult. She got enough height off that. I don't think her shoulder affected her.
It didn't, and she got a 9-9 score there for that vault. Heading over to the anchor spot, Rena Zachariah there from Michigan. Austin Shepherd originally slated into this spot, scratched here for the co-captain.
Again, that one-legged front tuck to a back tuck. Very solid. Get to see bonus points for that connection. Switch side.
Sometimes it's just a coach's feel to make this call. Austin Shepherd slated all the last couple days to be in this anchor spot. Liv Crocky watching warm-ups decides to go with Zachariah here in this position. And your dismount.
Layout call, stock landing. I'd say the coach decided well.
Of that fist pump in there from Liv Crocky. She is happy with her team's performance there. A big rebounding performance from last week there for the Wolverines. Lisa Burke finishing things off here in the anchor spot for Michigan State. A season high 9.85 last weekend to finish third in this event.
Giant fall to her shoot over. Great hit on her handstand there. Trying to get for a dismount. Double layout. Great extension.
And that was moments ago. 9.85 there for Lisa Burke. Angel Metcalf moments ago just finishing up her floor routine here for Iowa.
Something I love about Iowa's floor is that every single girl, when they're dancing their choreography, the entire team is dancing along with them.
So much energy and enthusiasm here for the Hawkeyes.
Layout 1.5, front layout.
And some high scores there in that event for the Hawkeyes. We'll tell you exactly who is Angel Metcalf. Wrapping things up there for Iowa. So three rotations now down. We have one more to go between these teams trying to be in the lead going into the evening session. Who will it be? The answer coming up next. You can always hear from BTN personalities, get programming information, and so much more. Follow the BTN on Twitter today. Welcome back to the Women's Gymnastics Championships here from Happy Valley, presented by Pure Silk. A reminder there, you can follow us on Twitter. It's a social media world. After the third rotation, Iowa's head coach Larissa Libby joining us now. And coach, I know Hare, Drenth, and Metcalf finished floor for you, either tying a career high or setting a career high. What did you see from those three events to finish off floor for you guys?
You know, I'm so sad that we didn't start waking up until the third event. I think they just got a little nervous. When you're in the likes of Michigan, Ohio State, I mean, this is one of the best conferences in the nation. So I just think the kids that we have came out a little bit tentative, but I'm excited to see that they've kind of shaken themselves out of that, woken up a little bit, and got down to the details that I know they're capable of doing.
And coach, being at championships, you have one event left. What's the mentality the girls have going into the last one?
Well, we told them, you know, after floor, they're willing to give you scores. Just go after it. We just want them to be aggressive, strong. We told them they've got nothing to lose, everything to gain, to stay focused on themselves and that their talent and their teamwork is enough.
All right. Thank you.
Thanks.
always so fired up after listening to
this. I know. It's so motivating.
Buckeyes on the vaults after the third rotation. You see Sarah Miller with that 9-9, and it was a great performance. I mentioned that she had that shoulder injury off the block. Not affected at all.
Not at all.
That's a big vault that they haven't seen from her in the last maybe 2 or 3 weeks. Michigan State warming up on the beam, but this is what they did in their third rotation there on the bars. Alina Cartwright, the leader here on this team, a 9.975. Here's another look at her dismount. That's Lisa Burt, but Alina Cartwright, as we had mentioned, with the high score there. But we took a look there at Lisa Burt's routine with a 9.85, and Alina Cartwright with the 9.775. So, excuse me, that Lisa Burt was the one who led the way there from Michigan State. And there is Nicole Arts there from Michigan. And for the Iowa Hawkeyes, you mentioned Metcalf and Hera Trent, they either tied or set a career high. The last three events so strong there for the Iowa Hawkeyes as they get set there to warm up on the vault. Heading back to our conversation about Michigan leading the way here at a 147.85, leading the way over Iowa, Michigan State, and Ohio State. Again, the goal is to get a mid 197 score here going into the fourth and final rotation here for Michigan. It's certainly attainable. This is their best event.
Going into floor, there's not as much pressure as bars or beams, so they can kind of let loose, go big, and get those big scores they need.
See Michigan State preparing to go on the beam, and some last-minute advice there from Kathy Klegas. Iowa warming up there on the vault, and Ohio State on the bars. Now the Wolverines and their performance on the beam in that third rotation, so important. Beth Plotke telling me she had, well, they had a count of fall last week for the first time this season, but they had two falls in their lineup. And Coach Plotke saying that that is something that she has not seen in her 25 years in coaching. And it wasn't necessarily the first fall from those two gymnasts, it was the second fall that hurt them, because they didn't get the bonus points after that second fall. So we look at Michigan here on the floor. Sachi Sugiyama, third straight week in the leadoff spot. From start to finish, and what a way to start the floor there for the Wolverines. Heading over to the vault for Iowa. Moments ago, Caroline McCready. She has done vault all year. One of the walk-ons here for the Hawkeyes, her only event.
In for your Tango Layout call. Not too much height off the ball and a little bit of form break, but sticks the landing. It's the most important part.
Moments ago, Sarah Grady for Ohio State on the bars. Her third event this afternoon.
Transition to the bar, shoot over, hits her handstand. Running it for a dismount. back landing. Nice job. Again, not as difficult of a routine, but very good, very consistent.
Sarah Grady reporting a 9.75 there on that event. We head over to Brooke Parker. Fourth straight meet, and she has been on the floor. The transfer from Alabama.
Huge double Arabian. A little too much power there. She kind of falls forward, but catches herself at least.
Reporter Sachi Sugiyama recording a 9.9 there on the floor in the leadoff spot.
Front pike step out to a double back. Again, she just has a little too much energy. She's over rotating everything a little bit. I think she's getting a little excited.
Their teammates are getting excited too. Look at them there in the background. And they have to stand and stay in that corral here for the championships, something that's different than what they have to do throughout the whole season.
That's kind of here. Round off double pike, under rotate a little bit, but her knees and her hands didn't appear to touch, so they won't take a fall for that.
And still smiling. So Sugiyama reporting the 9.9 before her. We'll head back to Iowa and Sydney Hare on the vault in the second spot there for the Hawkeyes. Michigan needs a 49.65 to get a 197.5 for the afternoon, which is right around what their goal is. We'll have to keep an eye on that. Here is Sydney Hare on vault for Iowa.
Another Yurchenko layout fall. Great hike. Great extension. Good ball.
Recording a 9.775 there on that vault. It was moments ago there for Sydney Hare. Tamil Funchess. We've seen the freshman perform solidly all afternoon long here for Ohio State.
Opening up with a giant half to a huge jigger. Straight to her transition to the low bar. Double back. Couldn't really see it landing there. I think she's
stuck. Someone's got to tell the coach to move.
Yeah. He's in our camera shot.
Tenille Funchess, that was moments ago, recording the 9.8. Back live here, Natalie Bielstein, a red shirt senior here for the Wolverines. Following up the 9.675 from Brooke Parker and the 9.9 from Sugiyama.
She's got a lot of attitude on this one.
She does. Fun to watch.
Opens up with a full twisting double back.
And how high did she get on that?
She almost touched the ceiling, I think.
A two-time NCAA All-American, second team in 2011, first team in 2010 on the floor.
Second pass here. Round off, 1.5 layout, punch layout, showing great control on her landing. You can see the teammates back there dancing with her, getting ready for her last pass. Round off, front layout, double twist, front layout, very difficult.
Michigan's having fun today. Just a moment ago, Maggie Dunn for Ohio State there on the bars. Saw her on beam and on four as well today.
Doesn't quite get as much height as the other girls we've seen. transition to a shoot over. Again, not quite hitting the handstand. Double layout, stuck landing. Good way to finish.
Maggie Dunn, that was happening moments ago, the 9-8. So back-to-back 9-8s there for Tennille Funchess and Maggie Dunn. Back over to Allie Glover on the vault for Iowa.
Jingle layout full. Judges will probably take a couple tens for a landing.
And there was a 9-8 there for Allie Glover. Let's head back. It's like you're a judge. Sean Johnson.
I don't want to be one.
It's a tough job. Natalie Bielstein tying a career high with a 9.95. Right now you're looking at Nicole Arts from Michigan.
She has a huge opening pass here. Full twisting, double pike. Under-rotated a tiny bit. It's always hard to land on those extra mounts.
To the All-Big Ten second team here this week. Nicole Arts, just a freshman. Solid contributor here for the Wolverines. Remember, Michigan kind of eyeing a 49.65 here in this event to get in the mid-197s. Performances up for Michigan, four hit routines there on floor. Samantha Kent there for Ohio State on the bars. There for Samantha Kent. Ashley Edlin, one to go here for Iowa on the ball. Another freshman here for the Hawkeyes.
Pachinko there at half. Great height off the ball, just landing.
Her score coming in, tying a season and career high at 9-8.
Interesting way to walk up. Walks out on top of her toes.
You get bonus points before your team starts on that? I'm kidding. Rita Zachariah,
so.
Here a captain. We saw her. An important routine there on beam.
What's funny is I know a lot of gymnasts and a lot of teams have traditions and superstitions. So I wonder if walking out
if that's her superstition.
Huge opening pass there, running double front with a stuck landing. It's a lot of difficulty for that pass. Having fun with our choreography. Front layout full, front layout.
Talk about showmanship. One of the seniors, this will be her last Big Ten championship.
Great way to end it then. Round up, double pike. Great landing.
Michigan on fire. And they still have their best floor competitor yet to come. Your State Farm State of Success, 20 Big Ten titles, 19 in the championship, one regular season last year, and the 20 NCAA appearances. Let's take a look here. Rima Zachariah and her final pass.
Huge double pike.
Lots of smiles going around here for the Wolverines. Head over to Angel Metcalf for Iowa, who is just a few percentage points behind Joanna Sampson in the all-around competition coming into this fourth rotation.
Jango layout full, great height and extension. Again, it's just that landing.
So Angel Metcalf reporting the 9-8. And Joanna Sampson competing against her in the all-around. Wrapping up the floor here from Michigan. This is your 2013 defending champ here on this event.
First pass here. Opens up with a huge double layout. Again, something you really only see in elite-level gymnastics, but she should probably be amongst them.
She is an elite gymnast for sure. A two-time All-Big Ten first team. Three-time All-American. A two-time captain.
Second pass, front layout, pull, front layout. Something about her, she shows such control on all of her skills and all of her landings. It makes her routines flawless. Last pass here. And run for a huge double pipe, stuck landing.
Joanna Sampson, her last time you'll see her on floor in a Big Ten competition. Her final pass coming up. She needs a better than a 9.825 to be in the lead for the all-around competition.
She got it!
She got a 10! As we look at Victoria Athlete at Ohio State, Joanna Sampson's score coming in as a 10. We'll get back to that in just a second. We're watching right now Apley for Ohio State, an all-arounder.
Landing. Beautiful dismount.
Wow. This Michigan team absolutely erupted. The first perfect 10 for Michigan since 2011 when Kylie Vodderman did it on the vault.
I have chills.
My goodness, the perfect 10s in championship history. She is the first on floor in championship history. And look at the tears rolling down. How fitting is that? Her last championship showing, absolutely perfect.
Coach from Hug. No better way to finish a competition than with a perfect 10.
Ugh. Unbelievable performance, a perfect performance for one of the elite gymnasts in Big Ten history. We'll wrap things up here when we come back. Gymnastics on BTN, presented by Pure Silk Moisturizing Shave Cream for Women, for legs that look and feel like pure silk. What an emotional event on the floor to finish with a perfect 10. And Michigan's head coach, Bev Blocky, now joining us. Just take us through your emotions.
It's just such a dream come true to come to this championship and perform in the way that we did out of the afternoon session after the performance that we had last week that we were so disappointed with. And, you know, we came here to make a statement. I think that we did it. And, you know, hopefully the scores will hold through the evening session. But I'm very, very proud of my team and so happy for my seniors and for Joanna. And with a perfect 10 like that is just incredible.
Coach, it was definitely a redemption. But talking about Joanna, this is her last season. To hit all four routines again, I think that's 43 out of 43 routines hit this season. You know, what have you said to her? What's her mentality right now?
Well, we don't really talk a lot about hit percentages because I think that puts pressure on athletes that they don't need. They need to just worry about the routine that they're doing at the time. And she's just been so incredibly rock solid, you know, as is my whole entire team this year. I think last weekend we're the only fall that we counted this season. So I could not be happier with our performance. Like I said, we're anxious to enjoy the afternoon and come back and watch tonight's competition.
Well, yeah, it's easier to enjoy when you get a 197.55. You said yesterday, we want to get in the mid-197s. You now accomplished that. What do you tell your team now that you have to sit through several hours here to see if you will be the Big Ten champion at the end of the night?
Just to have faith in what we did and the statement that we made and hope that, you know, the officials will measure everything that they see tonight against what they saw this afternoon, regardless of whether it was us or another team. I mean, that's the objective, is to compare the best gymnastics to the best gymnastics and not let things begin to escalate. So, you know, we have faith in the officials. I think that they understand what their job is this evening, and we're just going to believe in that and come back and watch the competition and hope that these scores hold.
All right. Well, it was fun to watch. Thank you for your time.
All right. Thank you.
A loose and focused Michigan team here this afternoon. We'll go through your fourth rotation results. Jordan Doherty and Allie Glover and Ashley Edlin and Angel Metcalf with the top scores there for Iowa. We go and look at the bars here for the Buckeyes as they wrapped up their fourth rotation. Melanie Schaefer competed in the all-around competition with the 9-9. We'll take a look at her routine. Your beam results here for Michigan State, Alina Cartwright pacing the way with Alex Pace right behind her. Cartwright, a little bit of her routine there on beam. And Joanna Sampson, the perfect 10. The anchor on the floor and the final time she will be competing in the championships.
Still gives me chills.
Her team reaction was classic when that score went up. And here is her final pass.
Every gymnast dreams of that perfect 10.
Ugh. They said the first for Michigan since 2011 and the first floor 10 here in the championships, no matter what school. Your results, Michigan won it in the mid-197s. They got the mid-197s.
Exactly.
Followed there by Ohio State in second place, I should say right now, but again, we have the four teams competing here in the evening session. So Michigan in the lead, heading towards that evening session with the top four seeds competing. Minnesota, Penn State, Nebraska, and Illinois will be your teams competing for the evening session. And Michigan will have to sit and watch. Joining us now, the perfect 10, Joanna Sampson, the first in your collegiate career. What was it like to see that score go up?
I mean, I immediately broke into tears. I've been working towards it for the last couple of years, and to finally get it, especially at Big Ten Championships, means a lot.
And Joanna, congratulations. I know every gymnast's dream is to get that perfect 10. For it to be on your last routine, last event, you've hit 100% this season for your team. I mean, what are you thinking now sitting through the next session, watching the scores hold up?
I mean, thinking now, I'm just really proud of how our team did. We came out and did exactly what we needed to do. We got out there, hit every routine that we needed to hit, put up a good score, and now we just sit back and watch and see how the scores hold up in the next session.
Joanna,
hope for the best.
You looked so loose and so focused. You didn't get the performance that you wanted last weekend.
Yes.
What was the biggest difference for this team?
I don't know. It's hard to say. I think this weekend we were just very good at having a good level of being loose and focused and confident. I think last week we got a little too uptight and focused a little bit too much on things. And this weekend we really just focused on the process and made sure we did one thing at a time, one landing at a time, one routine at a time. And it definitely worked out for us.
You've been in the situation where you've had to sit and watch a couple years ago.
Yeah.
You got to do it again.
Yeah, I mean, good. I mean, I wish all of the teams in the next session the best of luck. They deserve to be in that session, and I mean, hopefully our score holds out, but I definitely wish them good luck.
Well, congratulations
Thank
on
you.
The perfect 10.
Thank you.
Our Pure Silk performance of the meet, Joanna Sampson, the senior, the three-time All-American, and the 10th perfect score in championship history. The first session results, you see Shepherd and Bielstein and Miller. Those are your top scores here for that event. And for bars, Sampson, Sugiyama, Bielstein, and Schaefer. Those are the top scores or the leading scores going into the evening session. And for Bean, Artson, Metcalf, and Miller, and in the floor. That 10's going to be tough to beat going into that evening session. Bielstein there in second place so far. Well, we hope you enjoyed this afternoon session. If that's not enough gymnastics for you, guess what? We have another couple hours here coming up with the top four seeds here competing. And Michigan trying to hold up that score going into that evening session. That'll wrap it up from session number one. Michigan in the lead, Joanna Sampson in the lead for the all-around. Join us right back here at State College at 5 p.m. for session number two, Illinois, Minnesota, Nebraska, Penn State. For Sean Johnson, I'm Lisa Byington. We'll see you.